Now let's dive deep. And one of the things I'm going to ask you to maybe jot down or contemplate if you're emotional, and remember, go back to the beginning of your personal experience with human design. Do you remember when human design found you, when you came across it, when it began for you, that you unlocked through your strategy and honoring your authority, that you began to unlock the true authentic nature of who you were? Because when you can remember back to that time when human design made a strong, powerful difference in your life, and you can convey that empowerment to another by understanding and not only sympathizing, but comprehending and having compassion for the dilemma that is there in not only your own chart, but especially with the charts of the people that you're working with, when you can grasp the fundamental essence of the pain points and help to unravel those knots of karma and challenge and suffering with your client. Those are the places, those sensitive areas of pain and suffering, that you can really stand out from the competition with regards to not you having competition with others, with regards to others in human design, but with regards to the competitiveness of what is bombarding your client, the conditioned world, from all sides, all around them. Okay, your competition for that person's attention is everything else the not self identifies with regards to what's important in their life. Okay, so when you can immediately hit upon that pain point, I can say for me, the pain point for me was that feeling of inherent lack or of value, of worthiness, of ability to achieve or prove. And so what does the not self do? It tries to negate that pain by doing everything in its power to prove how good it is, how it is or is not about this or that. So the strategies inside the mind are the things that are holding and locking you and your client into the pain points, into the suffering. So if you can remember that beginning when you started to experience the success, the satisfaction, the peace, the surprise of living in alignment and what that the fruits of that brought to the table, to your experience, that's the thing that's going to make a difference, a shift in not only your life, but can continue to unravel and then unlock your potential. But also when you convey the importance of identifying with those sensitive pain points and realizing that no longer do you have to be bound by the shackles of those pain points, that suffering, that mind distortion that makes you think that you have to, must, should do those things that the mind convinces you, cajoles you. And it's the mind is simply a collection of thoughts and feelings and experiences and expressions that have been gathered throughout the life. It's just conditioning. It's always plagued by conditioning. So we can let go of that conditioning if we can identify it. And that is the job of a living your design guide. That is your task. Should you choose to accept, you know, picking up the baton and carrying on this flame that Ra ignited for all of us who use human design in alignment with our work. So Ra Uruhu, we are celebrating 35 years of the voice having brought the system through its mouthpiece, through Ra, into the world. And Ra was an amazing 5-1 manifester. His way is not your way, is not my way, but he did lay out a foundation of the way for us to use this system with regards to helping humanity foster a better reality for all of us through alignment with truth. And that alignment with truth has to begin with you. So moving forward in this, it's important for you to recognize, are you correct in taking this next step? Whether you are going to use this system for yourself and your family and friends, for your business, for your career, for your advising or coaching practice, for your psychological, what have you. Moving forward in this means that you've accepted the truth and the surrender of to the truth that the body is this one precious life that we live, and that the mind is an observer, a witness to that life, not in control. The sooner you can let go with the identification with I inside the head about the self, the sooner you can begin to live the fullest expression of this human being in this human form. So again, hi, I'm Lavina. I'm a certified Living Your Design Guide teacher, trainer. You can see in December of 2018, I began teaching human design guides and helping you to awaken not only to your truth, but help also to ignite that flame within each individual that you come into contact with. And it's one of the most powerful gifts, one of the most precious things you can do, and one of the most important professionals that we have is living your design as a guide. That is the truth. Now, I'm also a person who has studied BG5, which is the career and business track of the human design system. And that's one of the things that I'm going to bring into this, is to help you become aware of the levels to which you are here to be successful in a partnership with the environment. So that's one of the things, as well as the profit potentials that are there within your own design. And I offer this as a gift to my students without any kind of asking for anything back. It's part of the business of using human design to open the door to the true self. Because remember, the moment you stop being in control of your life is perfectly financed. And oftentimes you come to human design, you know, going, wow, this is amazing. You're so interested in it. You're so passionate about it. You see the difference it makes in your life. And you also want to use this tool out in the world. One of the things BG5 can help us with is helping us to recognize consciously and leverage those strengths, talents, and gifts that you have in your design in order to recognize how you are here to be recognized by others if you're a projector, or to respond in satisfaction to having life use you in the correct aligned way that you are designed to be used if you are a generator, because that energy is there to be used up satisfyingly so that you can be who you are for yourself in this life to generate life. You are the life force on this planet. Or if you're a manifester, to initiate, to inform in order to impact. Your life will be perfectly financed when you align to the signature of your design. Maybe it's the sweetness of success as it is for me, or maybe it's the surprise in life if you are a reflector. But remember, you must enter into using human design correctly as the energy inside of you is drawn towards using it. And then your life is perfectly financed. Not going to say that it's a cakewalk, but it's going to feel sweet. Even those challenges will be sweet if you're a projector. Even those frustrations that maybe come arise like a flash in the pan, you'll be able to mitigate that frustration with alignment with your truth and come back home to the satisfaction of opening the door to not only your true self, because you must do this for you first, generator, but also to help hand that key over to the other so that they too can unlock the door to their true self. We are guides. We facilitate. We don't do this for others. They must come into it correctly as well and do it for themselves, because this is about the fulfillment of purpose. Now, in Ra's words, human design isn't for everyone. It'll never be for everyone. It's for those that are ready. That readiness is a serendipity. It's a door opening slightly. It's that moment of possibility, the possibility of being able truly to go a different way. It's time to go a different way. It's time to go the way of ourselves, what we are as beings, nine centers, centered beings. And that, my friends, is what you're here to do. Help open that door slightly. And allow that person to walk in the fullness of the fulfillment of their highest truth and purpose. In order to open that door must be blown wide open within you. And that is one of the aims of this course, is to help open that door completely, utterly, fully, everything that you learned in the foundations of human design, we are now going to put that into practice with regards to how do we apply this knowledge not only to you, but also with our clients? How do we implement the intricacies, our awareness of that body graph, translate that body graph into plain English speak so that it is, I don't want to say dumbed down, but simplified so that even the most challenged with regards to the fog of the not self purpose, even the most challenged of us can hear that call of their own being drawing them towards truth. Not that we have power over anyone, but that we are helping to draw them, call them towards. Ra wanted each of you guides, of us guides, to be individuals that now brought in good conditioning that is absolutely required in order for people to realign to their truth, because they've been pulled away from their truth for decades, for the most part.